Hello friends, welcome to UGPG Mathematics. In this video, I am going to solve a problem from GATE exam. For more videos, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you. Now let us see the question. The question is about the determinant of a matrix B, where this B is A cube minus A square minus 4A plus 5A. Now the matrix A is given. Now we will use Kelly's theorem to find out the determinant of matrix B. So, by Kelly's theorem, we know that every matrix satisfies its own characteristic polynomial. So, first you find out the characteristic polynomial of A. So, for that, you just calculate determinant of lambda I minus A is equal to 0. So, this gives us determinant of lambda minus 1, 0, 1, 1, lambda minus 2, 0, then 0, 0 and lambda plus 2, the equation is, the determinant is 0. Now you solve the determinant. Now to solve this determinant, note that these two entries are 0. So I am calculating the determinant from this side. So the determinant is just lambda plus 2 into the determinant of this part, that is lambda minus 1 into lambda minus 2. And it equated to 0. So this gives us lambda minus 1 into lambda square minus 4 is equal to 0, because we know that lambda a minus b into a plus b is equal to a square minus b square. So I have written it lambda square minus 4. Now you just simplify this, so we'll get lambda cube minus 4 lambda minus lambda square plus 4 is equal to 0, and hence we get lambda cube minus lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 4 is equal to 0. Now we know that the matrix A satisfies this polynomial. That means A cube minus A square minus 4A plus 4 times identity matrix is equal to 0. Now we have given that this B square, B is the matrix A cube minus A square minus 4A plus 5 times identity. And you can write this B as A cube minus A square as it is, minus 4A as it is, plus 4A. You split this 5A as 4A plus 4 identity plus identity matrix, 4I plus I. So we'll get A cube minus A square minus 4A plus 4 times identity plus identity. So this is just 5 times identity matrix. Now use that this whole thing is equal to 0, and we will get that this B is just, this thing is 0. So 0 plus identity matrix. So this is just identity matrix. And now we have asked about the determinant of matrix B. So determinant of identity matrix is just 1, and hence the answer is 1. So note the trick. The trick is, every matrix satisfies its characteristic polynomial, and we know how to find out the characteristic polynomial. Now let us solve another question. So the question is of similar type. Let A is equal to 3, 1, 1, 3, and we have asked about sum of all eigenvalues of the matrix. Now this matrix is given by, this matrix M is A square minus 4 times A inverse. Now it is difficult to find out A square and A inverse, and then find M, and then find out eigenvalues of M. So we will use a trick, the same trick as we have used before, that every matrix satisfies its characteristic polynomial. So find out the characteristic polynomial of A. So you just use determinant of lambda I minus A equal to 0. So this is lambda minus 3 minus 1 minus 1 lambda minus 3. And now this gives us lambda minus 3 the whole square minus 1 is equal to 0. And therefore we have lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 9 minus 1 is equal to 0, and which again gives lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 8 is equal to 0. And now just use that. The matrix satisfies the polynomial. So we will get a square minus 6 times a plus 8 times identity matrix is equal to 0. And now we know that the determinant of a is non-zero because determinant is 3 into 3 is 9 minus 1 is 8. So a inverse exists. And now you just multiply throughout this equation by a inverse and we'll get a square into a inverse is just a minus 6 times a into a inverse is identity plus 8 into identity matrix into a inverse is just a inverse and 0 into a inverse is 0. Now so from this we will get the a inverse, the value of a inverse. So a inverse is 6 times identity matrix, you take it to the right side, right hand side, then minus a and divide by this 8 is just a scalar, so put it on the denominator. So now we want m, so m is a square minus 4 times a inverse is just 6 times identity matrix minus a divided by 8. Now simplify this, so this is just a square plus a divided by 2 minus 3 times identity matrix. Now we know that one important theorem, that if this is again important, if lambda is eigenvalue of matrix A, then lambda square is eigenvalue of matrix A square. So you just use this to find out the eigenvalues of matrix M. So now lambda is, so first you find out the eigenvalues of A. So for eigenvalues of A, you just solve this characteristic polynomial. And so roots of this characteristic polynomial are just eigenvalues of the matrix A. So we want the product is 8 and the sum of the roots are 6 and product of roots is 8. So these are roots. So lambda is just 4 and 2. So the eigenvalues are 2 and 4 of the matrix A. And hence lambda square is just 16 and 4 are the eigenvalues of A square from this note. And now we will use an important theorem, which is the trick for this example. So it is just, suppose we have a polynomial in A, so let us denote it by P of A. If P of A is the polynomial in A, then and if we have lambda is eigenvalue of matrix A, then P of lambda is eigenvalue of the polynomial P of A, which is a polynomial in matrix form. So here we have to find out the eigenvalues for this matrix M. Now M is just a polynomial in the matrix form, which is A square by A by plus A by 2 minus 3 times identity matrix. So you let here P of A is equal to the polynomial, which is A square plus A by 2 minus 3 times identity matrix. Now p of lambda is just, you replace this a by lambda. So this is just lambda square plus lambda by 2 minus 3. Now identity matrix in terms of numbers, it is just 1. So we get this polynomial p of lambda. Now we know that this if lambda is eigenvalue of a, then p of lambda is eigenvalue of the polynomial eigenvalue of p of a. So you just put the value of lambda. So if lambda is equal to 2, because we have two eigenvalues, lambda equal to 2 and lambda equal to 4. So for lambda equal to 2, we will get 2 square plus 2 by 2 is 1 minus 3, which is 4 plus 1 minus 3 is 2. And when it is 4, it is 4 square plus 4 by 2 is 2 and minus 3. So it is 16 minus 1, it is just 15. And hence, we will get the eigenvalues of the matrix M, which is defined by a square plus a by 2 minus 3i, are the eigenvalues 2 and 15. But the question is about the sum of eigenvalues, and hence the answer is 2 plus 15, which is just equal to 17. So in this question, we have used that it first satisfies the Cayley's theorem. By Cayley's theorem, it satisfies the characteristic polynomial. And then we have used that if lambda is eigenvalue of the matrix A, and then p of lambda is eigenvalue of the matrix P of A, where P of A is the polynomial in A. Now let us move to another question. So question is, which of the following matrices is singular? Singular means the determinant. So trick is, we want determinant to be 0. So this is just one thing about this problem. So let us find out the determinant. So orally we can do. So the determinant is 2 into 3 is 6 minus 5. So determinant is non-zero. That means this is not the answer. Now the determinant of this is 3 into 3 is 9 minus 2 into 2 is 4. So determinant is 9 minus 4, which is 5, which is again not zero. Now the determinant of this is 2 into 6 is 12 minus 3 into 4 is 12. So 12 minus 12 is 0. Hence this is the singular matrix. And so don't calculate the determinant of this matrix. So the answer is the matrix 2, 4, 3, 6. Now the next question is about the inverse of a given matrix Q. Now this Q is given by 3, 3 by 7, 2 by 7, 6 by 7, then minus of 6 by 7, 3 by 7, 2 by 7, then 2 by 7, 6 by 7, and minus 3 by 7. Now it is difficult to find out the inverse by our usual method. So we first note that this matrix Q is orthogonal matrix, because if you take any two rows from the matrix Q, then their inner product is zero. Or you just take the dot product of the two vectors, row vectors, then it will be zero. For example, you take the first row and second row, and you just, so the first row is 3, 2, 6, and the second row is minus 6, 3, and 2. Now this whole thing is divided by 7. The 7 does not matter, but when taking the dot product, because you want ultimately it to be 0. So you just multiply the corresponding entries. So the multiplication of first plus multiplication of second and plus multiplication of third entries. So 2 into minus 6 is minus 3 into minus 6 is minus 18 divided by 7 square. plus 2 into 3 is 6 by 7 square, and then plus 6 into 2 is 12 by 7 square. So this is just minus 18 plus 6 plus 12 is plus 18 by 7 square, which is 0 upon 7 square, so 0. And you can again take any two rows, as first row and third row, or second with third, the dot product will be 0. And this 7 is just the unit vector along the direction of rows. That is, when you take suppose you have this vector 3, 2, 6, then you just find out its norm. So the norm of the matrix, the vector V, is, you denote this by norm of V. So it is 3 square plus 2 square plus 6 square, or just magnitude of V is just 7. So they have just divided by 7. And so the property of such matrices is just, when you have such orthogonal matrix, then by the definition of orthogonal matrix, we have A into A transpose is equal to identity matrix, and which is same as A transpose into A. So this clearly implies this A transpose is the inverse of A. So this is the trick for this example. So it is now enough to find out the transpose of the given matrix. So all of you know that, how to find out the transpose. So I will write down here the transpose of Q as just Q inverse, and this is what we have to find out, and it is just equal to find out the transpose. So it is 3 by 7, 2 by 7, 6 by 7, minus 6 by 7, 3 by 7, again this is 2 by 7, and last is 2 by 7, 6 by 7, minus 3 by 7. That means you transfer the rows into columns. So the option is C. Now let us solve another question. So question is about, we have given a matrix, a 5 by 5 matrix A, and also we have the matrix A has only one real eigenvalue, and then we have to find out the real eigenvalue of the matrix A, and the options are given. Now the eigenvalue can be anything. So to find out the eigenvalue, the procedure is to find out determinant of the lambda I minus A, and then find out the roots of such polynomial, the characteristic polynomial, and then we'll get eigenvalues. Now it is 5 by 5 matrix, so it is difficult to find out all the eigenvalues, but the trick is, here we have given that the matrix is of size 5 by 5, correct? So it has 5 eigenvalues, maybe repeated or distinct, but 5 eigenvalues, it's just necessary. Now 5 eigenvalues with, they have given only one real eigenvalue, and the question is about what is that real eigenvalue, correct? So the real eigenvalue is just 1, so it has only one real eigenvalue, and we have to find out that real eigenvalue. So another 4 eigenvalues are just complex. So if 1 is the eigenvalue, then it's imaginary, complex conjugate is also eigenvalue. So there are 2 complex eigenvalues, and the other 2 are its complex conjugate. So the 5th real eigenvalue is, to find out this eigenvalue, we should note that if you add all the entries of the matrix, the row entries or the column entries, then it will get a same number. So here the row entry is just 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 is equal to 15. Similarly, you add all the entries of second row, so again we will get 15. For third row also we'll get 15. For fourth row we'll get 15. And the sum of fifth row, the entries of fifth row, we will again get the number 15. So here we have the important thing is from the linear algebra, if you write the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you just write the matrix A. So 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, then 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, and then 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Then we will get that 15 is the eigenvalue for this matrix. The number we will get when we just add the row entries of the matrix, and the eigenvector is just the one which consists of all the entries as just one. So the eigenvalue, the real eigenvalue is 15. So that here the important trick is when we have the row entries is equal to some number for all the rows, it is important. If you add all the entries of the row, and for all the rows we will get the same number, then that number is the eigenvalue of given matrix. Now let us solve another question. So the rank of matrix M, we have given the matrix as 5, 10, 10, 1, 0, 2 and 3, 6, 6. So just by looking at the matrix M, we will get that it is you just divide this first row by 5, we'll get 1, 2, 2. You keep second row as it is, and third row you just divide by 3. So it is 1, 2 and 2. Now note that this first row and second row, third row are same, correct? So while calculating the rank, you just take one independent row. So forget about this row or first row. So I am just not taking this third row. Now these 2 and 0 are not in the linear combination of each other. So from these two rows, these two rows are linearly independent, because one row is not a linear combination of other. We cannot write one row as some scalar multiple of second row and vice versa. Hence there are two linearly independent rows, and hence the rank is 2, because there are two linearly independent rows. Same thing, you can just take columns and you will get that the rank is again 2, or you just use another trick. The trick is that when you just multiply by 1 by 5 to first row and 1 by 3 to third row, we'll get 1, 2, 2, 1, 0, 2 and 1, 2, 2. We know that. Now since it is not a zero matrix, so 0 cannot be the rank. So you just strike out this option. Now again, we know that one row is dependent on the other. So this 3 is not the option. For if it is equal to 3, then it has to be invertible, or there must be 3 linearly independent rows or columns. So it is not the case. So 3 is not there. Now we have just the rank can be 1 or 2. Now another definition of rank is in terms of definition. So if you have any 2 by 2 minor of order 2, then you will get that rank as 2. If you have minor of less than 2, then you go for 1 and so on. So it is not 3, so you go for minor of order 2. Less than 3 is minor of order 2. So check whether you get some minor of order 2. That means you take any 2 by 2 submatrix of this matrix and see, check whether the determinant of that sub matrix is 0 or not. So if that is not 0, then rank is 2. So clearly we will get this sub matrix, or you can find any sub matrix. So for this sub matrix, we will get the determinant of this 2 to 0 2 as the determinant is 4, which is not 0, and hence it is there exists a minor of size 2 by 2 or minor of size 2, and hence the rank is 2. Thank you.